It's the last real big hit out before the games, and I want to get an edge over my competitors.
It's not a game where you go out and just do the same set plays every time. It's always new, it's always challenging.
The competition here in Perth is top. There's no one missing from the world's best, and it's going to be an awesome race.
To win a World Championships in a pre-Olympic year is huge. It's hard work.
I've won 5 World Championships in the 470, and I can't think of any better way than coming out with 6, especially in the home World Championships.
Beautiful Perth in Western Australia is playing host to the biggest international sailing regatta this year. 1,200 sailors from 79 nations competing in 800 boats. 10 world titles will be decided off the coast of Fremantle on 6 courses at this combined championship, one for each of the Olympic sailing classes. It's an impressive event that happens every 4 years, and sailors call it quite simply the world's. Pressure on the top athletes is intense because this is the main qualifier for the Olympic regatta. All are here to pull out a top performance at the Perth 2011 ISAF Sailing World Championships. So far we've had 10 cracking races in 4 fleets. Today, it's crunch time. The top 10 in laser radial 470 men, RSX and Finn, are fighting it out in the double point scoring medal races.
Definitely going to be physical.
We like this kind of fight.
Everyone wants the medal, win the medal.
The pressure is something that's made up in your own head.
And we are all quite close together, so everything can happen.
Sports is all about the present and never about the past.
We will enjoy today.
This is grandstand sailing of the new era. We'll see 4 new world champions crowned. Join us for the ride. In the laser radial class, the story of the week has been the battle between Dutch sailor Marit Bouwmeester, a fantastic downwind talent, putting pressure on Belgium Evie Van Acker's lead. Van Acker was top of the leaderboard until races 9 and 10 yesterday, when 2 mid-fleet finishes saw her lose that lead to Bouwmeester. Irish sailor Annalise Murphy revelled in the big wins to score 2 bullets, taking her up to 5th overall. American Paige Raley has been chipping away all week with consistent results, often the secret to winning world championships.
I just can't believe it. I wanted to have a good day today, but I didn't think I could win 2 races, so I can't be happier.
A great turnout now to watch the showdown final in the laser radial medal race.
Yeah, well, I'm happy that I got it in my own hands, but definitely Evie and Paige are really good competitors, so it's going to be a tough battle. Let's see how it goes.
5 seconds to go to the start of this race. The tension is there. In 30 minutes' time, we will have a world champion. The start is off. The battle expected to be between Bouwmeester from the Netherlands and Van Acker from Belgium. And now, rounding the top mark, it's New Zealand second, Great Britain third. Didn't quite see the leader, is that Murphy?
Well, that's a close manoeuvre by Evie there, coming into the mark on a port.
Love to see the leader, just to see who got around there as 007. Look who it is. Annalise Murphy headed over to the right-hand side of the course. Watch this, the Netherlands are coming into the mark with right of way. Everyone has to keep clear. This is a great bit of sailing when the pressure is on for Marit Bouwmeester from the Netherlands. Slipped past, almost slipped past into first. She just wants to get Sarah Winther, the Kiwi sailor who so nearly didn't qualify for this race, out of her way. Top mark, second time. Sarah wins the round. Marit Baumeister, adrenaline up. She must be excited. She bears down wind. She's second. She's in world championship winning form. Look at the Belgium sailor. Don't write her off. If the sailor from the Netherlands beats the sailor from Belgium, Evin Akker, the world title will go for Netherlands. But we now have a real race on for world championship glory. Evie Van Akker has taken the advantage. The Irish sailor Annelies Murphy could get in the mix as well. They are halfway up towards the top mark for the final time. Well, she's got quite a lead there.
She's done a beautiful job up that beat.
So top mark rounding Evie Van Akker puts her on 49 points. The Finnish sailor with... Well, we haven't seen Marit Baumeister. Oh, look, this is looking bad for Holland. If it stays like this, the world title could be going to Belgium. Minutes left in this race. Evie Van Akker started badly. Two penalties on her way to the top mark. It looked to be all over. And then somehow she found that extra gear, the composure. She sailed into the lead. Could she become the world champion? Needed more than that. Oh, no, she's been penalised, has she? She's doing a penalty turn there. We were talking about the anxiety at the front of the fleet. It's so easy to be perceived to be pushing and rocking too much.
Evie really needs two boats in between. Oh,
this has played into the hands of Marit Baumeister. Baumeister from the Netherlands is going to round this mark in third position, or is Evie Van Akker going to squeeze on the inside?
Looks like Marit is behind
Marit
Evie.
Marit is
here.
One place behind. So that looks like second for Evie, or is it third for Evie and fourth for Marit? Fourth for Marit is 49 points. She is the world champion. What a race that was. Smiling on board the boat. Relief, exhaustion. One place behind means that the world title goes to the Netherlands.
Oh, I knew great things were happening, so I was like, keep fighting. And yeah, difficult. I was like, it's not over till it's over, but it didn't look too good for me all the way down. I didn't really pick up my speed, but thank God Evie made a mistake as he got heavily paid by it.
So fantastic result for Marit Baumeister from the Netherlands. She takes the gold. Belgium's Evie Van Akker gets the silver and Paige Raley from the USA in the bronze medal position.
The defending world champions are sliding.
The 470 class has been all about two Australian heroes, Matthew Belcher and Malcolm Page, delivering superb results. Six race wins out of 10 is the equivalent of slamming the door on your opposition and all but nailing down the championship.
But it is Australia first.
Page is a gold medalist from Beijing in this class, five times world champion, and he's on track to become the most successful 470 sailor of all time.
Here come the Croatians, about 15 metres from the mark. They're going to hit, no, they're not.
Anything can happen in a medal race fight, but expect fireworks for second place between Croatians Fantala and Marinic and Brits Patience and Bithel tied on points. Before the 470 top 10 head out to the centre course, let's catch up with the front runners in the pit lane.
Pressure is something that's made up in your own head, you know what I mean, Stuart? You know, we worked hard for this regatta and we're in a good, great position and, you know, we're just grateful for the opportunity and excited more than anything else to go out there and tear it up in front of the crowd.
Obviously, we're just going to concentrate on the race, but if we hear a little cheer, I'm sure I'll hear it, but I look forward to it doing it in our home waters.
And that is the start. It's a great start by Croatia there, heading off towards the left-hand side.
Wow, and Luke and Stu have tacked away. They're hopefully seeing some breeze out on the right-hand side there. The other thing you'll notice is that the O flag's flying on the committee boat right now, and that's an open pumping rule.
So the British team saw a big wind shift. They weren't following the pack in towards the wall, which is usually pay. That's Luke Patience and Stuart Bithel. The likely outcome for them is a silver medal, but you can't do better than be at the front of the fleet. Well, here we go, coming in towards the top mark. It is the pair that your eyes are on. Luke Patience and Stuart Bithel not yet got their Olympic place decided. Extraordinary battle in this class, including the double Olympic silver medalist Nick Rogers. Belcher and Page up to sixth. It's start getting the glasses out. This gate here, you choose either one of the two marks. There's no surprise where most of the boats are going. They're heading to the right-hand side, and as I say that, the French decide to go...
Yeah, the only option they had there, really. There's so many boats to the left-hand side of them, they've got to take this other mark.
From Great Britain's perspective, Luke Patience and Stuart Bithell have gone to the left-hand side of the track. The rest of the fleet in their wake. And coming up to fourth, there's no need to do that, but they may as well. Belcher and Page, the men heading for a world title. That crew there, as low down as he can, hand behind the head, maximum leverage, his arm behind his head.
He's almost trying to make it look casual, isn't he?
Luke Patience and Stuart Bithell approaching this mark, a team who started so well and haven't looked back. Slight shift in the wind, slightly struggling to go around this top mark. No need to tack. Around we go. Spinnaker up, little pump of the sail. And behind them, the Greek combination come into the mark. And there's real distance now between the British team and the rest of the pack heading in. The Australians, though, are gently marching their way up through the fleet. And look at that, there's the world champion in waiting from Australia. Patience and Bithell leading the race, heading for silver. And bronze, well, at the moment it says Snow and Saunders, but in that last picture it was looking very much like Sima Fantella and Igor Marinich.
No, basically only four boats in this race that can actually come away with any silverware at all. And, you know, we're looking now, it looks reasonably confident that the Aussies have got that wrapped up. I mean, they're pumping that sail super hard there, working their way down the run. Even though they think they've got it wrapped up, you can't take your eye off, can you? You've just got to keep working max out the whole way.
Luke Patience can't wait to the end of this race.
I think the lads will be enjoying themselves now, actually. You know, they're looking more and more comfy. Their speed is clearly good. They're extending away from the fleet. Been able to pick and choose where they put themselves on the racetrack.
But the Australian team, I think perhaps the part of their tactic here was on that first leg. Let's just quite a few boats around, stay out of trouble, get into our groove and sail our own race, just see where we finish.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, you know, they maybe had some worrying moments at the top end of that first beat where Luke and Stuart extended and were leading and they were kind of back in sort of 8 and 9. But, you know, then it's not their first time, is it? And they'll be confident of their speed and knowing what they had to do. Just anything other than 10th was going to secure them a gold medal, and that would be easy enough for them, I'm sure. You know, look at the distance. The next team hasn't even rounded the final mark yet, and the lads for life are pretty much across the finish line. Here they come.
That is a silver medal for the British team. Yeah. This is the moment that started with expectation. Yeah. Has been completed.
There
victory for Australia. They are the world champions in the 470. They've made it look easy from the beginning. A big smile there on the face of both Matthew Belcher and Malcolm Page.
And this is the way the medals went. Croatia in bronze, Great Britain silver, Australia, the hometown heroes Belcher and Page get gold.
Great to do it in Australia. Hearing all the cheers throughout the race was great. I was trying to concentrate on my job, but it was really, really special.
What a result for Australia. We'll be back in a moment for two more medal races in the RSX and Finn classes. Welcome back to Western Australia and the Perth 2011 ISAF Sailing World Championships, where 1,200 athletes are fighting for world title honours and Olympic selection. We have two medal races coming up later in the Finn class, but now the RSX boards. The two superstars in the women's RSX class have struggled at this championship. Reigning world champion Blanca Manchon from Spain and four-time Olympic medalist Alessandra Sensini are just out of the medal race cut.
Her last chance, but she's not going to catch the leader.
This is a phenomenally difficult class. The aerobic effort is perhaps the most punishing of all the Olympic sailing disciplines. The class leader from the start has been Israeli Lee Korsitz, scoring top four results in all but one race, which she can now discard. But Marina Alabal from Spain is close enough on points to attack for the world title.
Well, these are live pictures from the RSX race course. Soon we'll be going into the countdown. The helicopters are up. We spoke to them, starting with the overall leader.
I cannot lose by 2 points, like two people. So I need to be, Zocha first, so I need to be four. Something like that. It's complicated, but I'm lead by 6 points.
My plan is enjoy on the water, you know? That's it. It's beautiful weather, sunny, hot, a little wind, like a 12 knots. Enough for enjoy, you know?
This is the final of the women's RSX, 10 seconds to go. In 15 seconds from now, the heart rates will be up. At the moment, stationary, waiting. 3, 2, 1, and the leader overall going into this, Lee Causes is off, closest to the start boat. And just as Nick Dempsey was saying, this is the power, this is the pressure, this is so physically demanded. Poland have got a good start too, Spain are up there, so the top three have all got good starts. Nick Dempsey is looking from the commentary box out on the racetrack.
Sophia and Marina are out on the left-hand side, and Sophia's starting to roll, sail over the top of Marina. I'd say it's definitely advantage Poland right now.
Jessica.
They are dying. As you can see, they're not stopping.
Sophia's just tacked. That's really tight. Marina's going to go with her. She's got to go with her. All she's got to do is beat her, and I think Marina's slightly better downwind.
And it is the Polish sailor, Zofia Klepacka, who's coming towards the top mark in first position.
Well, this is going to be tight here. Marina's tacked quite early on the lay line. If she can make it around the mark, she's going to be looking good, but she's stopping. She's got weed on her fin, unfortunately. So Sophia's just clearing her fin, getting the weed off the fin before the long downwind.
Big pumping downwind, top mark, last time.
This is Sophia going around, and Marina's right on her tail, so this is going to be really close because those two are now fighting for the titles.
Calls it in fifth at the moment, third and second Klepacka. She's still got a chance to win the world title.
She is
it
pumping
couldn't be
hard
closer,
now.
Though. Well, the Polish sailor at the moment is heading downwind in world championship winning form and in world championship winning place.
This is Lee and the French girl. They're together. If Lee can pass her on this reach, she will win the world title. Or if the Chinese girl passes Sophia, yeah, who she is planing up behind.
Well, that
is close.
Will come to us in a moment.
This is so close.
We've got one.
Okay,
result
so Sophia's going to cross the
so
line.
So let's just get this. If Lee Causes finishes fifth in the race, I think she will win the world title.
Yes.
Yeah.
Lee Causes from Israel finishes fifth. The Polish sailor finish is in second place. That is correct. We are looking to a world title.
Yeah,
yes, Lee's won.
Lee's won.
Heading to Israel.
Yeah. She fought back hard in that race. She did a fantastic job. She wasn't looking good, and it's not her conditions, and look at her.
And Spain are coming through. Celebrations for the Israelis.
Well, she's been dominant all week. Causes takes the gold for Israel. Klepacka from Poland gets the silver. Marina Alabau from Spain in bronze medal position. And China there in fourth.
We're the team, you know?
Yeah.
The chicken team.
We're training together. We are top three here. We are so happy.
We're drinking together.
Yeah.
We're happy together.
Celebrating together.
We cook dinners together. We
I'm
do
tired,
everything together.
Tired together.
And yeah, we win together. We win together, no?
The international jury played a major role in the Finn class yesterday by disqualifying four-time Olympic medalist Ben Ainslie in race 9. Ainslie was leading the regatta overall, but the jury decided that an outburst after the finish involving a media boat contravened the rarely used Rule 69 in sailing for behaviour. Ainslie is out of the top 10, leaving the door open for PJ Posma from the Netherlands and Giles Scott from Britain to duke it out for the world title.
Really tricky racing, very tight off the start line with that wall. You know, it'll be tight, all to play for.
The organisers are getting good value out of that Perth sign. Let's head to the Finn Park before they launch into their medal race.
Well, I've got PJ 3 points behind and Ed 9, they're the only two that can beat me. So that means I need to stay within one place of PJ and four of Ed.
We'll fight for it, we'll fight a fair fight, and may the best win.
That's the start. Oh, second gun, someone was over the line. That is British sailor, top of pitcher, and Ed Wright, number 11 there, the defending champion, heading back for two British sailing, a very poor start. So this is PJ Postmaer from Holland, second at the start of this race, heads downwind. Hauk Christensen from Denmark is just behind. And Giles Scott, the overall leader, is in third position. Postmaer could get into the lead. He has. That was his plan. Giles Scott third. Postmaer would win. At the moment, that title is heading to the Netherlands. Ahead, this will tell us the story so far, and it's a story that will please Giles Scott, but there's no means certain, because second, Hauk Christensen, there doesn't need to be much of a wind shift for him to slide into the place. And actually, that picture now is showing Scott in third, and if it stays like that, the world title goes to the Netherlands. Look at the right of the screen. There he comes, and that's exactly what Postmaer wants. Postmaer rounds the mark. Big rock, it's going to be very energetic. The fitness is going to come in. We talked about fitness with the boards. You just watch what's coming up now. Second, Denmark. Denmark doing the Netherlands a favour now, keeping Giles Scott off first position. So Scott is in third. What can he do? And this, at the moment, the story is as much about the Danish sailor as PJ Postmaer. And when the helicopter shot's looking down at him, watching that technique now, middle of the boat, pull now like that. And you can see, as he pulls, you can see more white water around the boat accelerates. Coming down to the bottom mark for the second time, PJ Postmaer at the moment is still on target for a world championship title, because the Danish sailor, Hauk Christensen, is ahead of Giles Scott from Great Britain. But if Scott can get past the Danish sailor, it will change the game. And the Danish sailor tacks. I can hear the cheers from the commentary box. Here comes Giles Scott. Let's see the order of they shuffle around the top markets. World title is now heading to the Netherlands. Giles Scott tacks. Postmaer rounds the top mark. He's defended his lead. Christensen second, Giles Scott third. This is the race to the finish. This is Giles Scott. Ahead of him, Hauk Christensen from Denmark. He's running out of runway and a big overtaking move there from Giles Scott. He got that right. Do that again, he'll go past. He's done it again. Giles Scott overtakes. Well, he's in a momentum now. Giles Scott got the momentum, sailed straight past. He's still going. And look at that, from behind him to a 21-metre advantage. Balance of power, Great Britain. Giles Scott holds the world title at the moment. Postmaer now is 20 metres away in a dying wind. Giles Scott behind is going to finish the championship of his life. He looks behind. The story is you were second. And the story is about to cross the line. This is Giles Scott. He looks under the boom. He says thank you. What must he be thinking? Victory for the British sailor. A little thumbs up, a twinkle and a wink.
Two medals for Great Britain. Giles Scott secures the gold. Peter Jan Postmaer gets the silver and Ed Wright bronze.
That race was so hectic. It's kind of all a bit of a shock if I'm honest. But yeah, I suppose I won, didn't I?
You could see the impact of winning a world title on Giles Scott's face. It's a big day for him and for all the medal race winners here in Western Australia. Let's share their emotions on the podium.
That's it. That's his moment. Giles Scott is the world champion. He came here wanting first, nothing less. First world title for the home nation here in Perth. Lee Corbett, what a champion. The three friends left the beach today with great aspirations. Three friends, all on the podium here. We'll be right back.
The Perth 2011 ISAF Sailing World Championships continues tomorrow and all next week for the remaining Olympic classes. But for now, what a day, especially for the four new world champions.